Hello everyone, hope you're having a magical day today. Today we are going to SeaWorld to check out the Christmas stuff. So let's go check it out. So you get here and here's the Christmas trees up front. And they do have social distancing markers in line to go through baggage checks. So I'm gonna read off my phone some of the things that you can get or that you can come to here at SeaWorld San Antonio. From now through January 3rd, you can get or come see Christmas. And yes, my glasses do fog up with the mask on, so bear with that. SeaWorld San Antonio is decking out the halls for the largest Christmas celebration in Texas, an extraordinary holiday event. This wintry, wet, watery wonderland features Christmas shows, holiday lights, festive food, Santa Claus, and more. You can see twinkling lights, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, Christmas shows, Elmo's Christmas Wish, Dinner with Santa, Merry Mariachis, Sesame Street Photo Ops, The Entertainment, and Elf's Christmas Story. During SeaWorld's Christmas celebration, join us at Christmas Cove as our acrobat chair stacking elf completes his list of Christmas tasks. Merry Mariachis, which we'll see here, The Story of Christmas. The angelic choir will tell the story of the birth of Christ through song. Orca Encounter. Ocean Discovery, a splash of Christmas. And Clyde and Seymour's Countdown to Christmas. Elmo's Christmas Wish. Join Cookie Monster, Rosetta, Grover, and Zoe as they help Elmo find his Christmas wish. So that's what you can see here at San Antonio SeaWorld. And with that, let's go check that out. So now we're past the gates. And you can see some Christmas lights already on the bushes here. And on the fence. So they don't have any maps, but they have this Go Digital for the schedule of shows and all. So I did that, the scanner QR code, and it takes you to the SeaWorld.com page, and so you can go there on your own if you want to learn more. So here's some Christmas lights as you first get into the park, and the Coca-Cola bear, I love it. We got some mariachi band here. So near the playground area, they have this nativity set. And I guess there's gonna be performers out here. There was last time. I don't know what time. Again, nothing, the online didn't say anything about what time or anything, so hopefully we can catch them a little bit later. And you have Elmo's Christmas Wish. There's the show times for it. So we're over by the Steel Eel, and I know it's hard to tell right now, but they do have the lights on. But the trees are all purple. And we'll come back by, see it at night. I think it's gonna look really awesome. Okay, so I really like this. You have a snowman in a Spurs shirt with a basketball as a head, and he shot his head in the goal. Oh no! And we got the Blues Brothers here. Oh wait, we're not at Universal. There's a Christmas tree that's not lit yet. I love how they get the Christmas lights in here. And we are in the Penguin House. And the Christmas lights is along the bottom of the rail here. Y'all know me and penguins. I love penguins. So, I'm pointing this out because I'm teaching it in science right now. And so, if you can tell, the water and the penguin is two different sizes. That's what we call refraction in the water. So the water bends the light. So that's why we see it two different sizes. Like that rock over there is a lot smaller up top than it is on bottom because of refraction. So I like the snowflakes on the fence here. And we got some melting snowmen. Oh wait, no. They're bullfighting snowmen. That is neat. And we have some football playing football snowmen over here. Oh look, I don't know if you can tell, but the football is over here because it went straight through the snowman. Then we have some western snowmen about to fight. I love how the wavebreaker is right there. So this is the entrance to it. Now on the screens they're portraying some Christmas stuff. I like the nutcrackers. And apparently they're supposed to light up because there's the cord is along the edge down there. Welcome to the town of Christmas Cove. Yay, we're in Christmas Cove, everybody. Here. This is near the bathrooms right here. I love the cowboy boots here. And the Christmas tree. I think this should be named Christmas Town. They have some players, some live music here.
Shining far through the shadows dim.
Visit Santa in his workshop. We're gonna go visit Santa in his workshop. And they do have physical distancing markers here. So we met Santa, and that was really fun. It was different this year with just having COVID, you know, got to do things differently. But that was really cool, actually. So as we turn around here, there's more Christmas lights. And we got mistletoe market here. And I love this tunnel again. I love where lights go all the way around you. But this time it's just icicles. Now again, we'll come back through when it's darker and see what it's like. Well, this is something new. The Turtle Reef, right here. Look at the big turtle. Oh, look, 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 look. Oh, so cool. We have Hanukkah here. I don't know if there's any performers or not, but there are speakers, so I'd assume so. And that's right by the Orca Stadium here. We have a photo op here with Rudolph and his friends. And unfortunately, I don't know any of the characters' names. And look, they're playing their reindeer games over here. And again, unfortunately, I don't know any of their names. Y'all tell me in the comments down below what their names are. I haven't seen Rudolph in so many years. I know, he's an abominable snowman. Hey, look, you can meet him. In the Sesame Street area, and you can see how empty it is. Now it is 4:20 on a Friday afternoon, the Friday right before Christmas break for students, and it is so empty in here. So I wanted to go check and see if Elmo and his friends was doing pictures or what was going on in here. And you got Oscar the Grouch here. And his Christmas. Here's some of the Christmas things you can buy. I love that red bird. And the holiday mask. It's $9.99. Can't tell what sizes they are.
Okay, so if you know me, I don't like roller coasters. And guess what I'm in line for? Right here. It's a kiddie one, but I'm in line for it. So we're gonna go check it out, and it is a Sesame Street here. We're gonna go check it out and have fun. All right, so I did it. It was actually kind of fun. Wasn't too scary at all. And a little scary, I'm not gonna lie. It was a little scary, but I figured, you know what? My sister did a plane ride this week. I could do a little roller coaster. So that's why I did a roller coaster. And you know what? I'm glad I did it. Conquer your fears, people. Conquer your fears.
Clyde and Seymour's countdown to Christmas.
And now the stars of our show, Clyde and Seymour.
Frosty, he'll be back again. Someday! obviously Seymour here is nice. So that leaves... Make sure Santa visits Clyde and Seymour?
Yes. And if all goes well, so we'll send it to the North Pole via
the Otter.
So we just got out of Clyde and Seymour's Christmas show, and I want to show you the Christmas lights here. Very pretty. So we're over by the Steel Eel again, but here's the Christmas lights. So beautiful. Purple. I'm gonna stop for a minute. I love the twinkling lights on the ground. So inside this store, I have a model train going. And I like the train station up here. That's really cool. The bridge. Here comes the train. It's moving pretty fast, actually. And here's another one. You think you picked up somebody for the North Pole? The Polar Express? Ha ha ha. That's the Penguin House there, with all the Christmas lights on it, or the icicles, I should say. I wonder why they did the icicles. There's that Christmas tree. That's pretty though, how they did it, all of icicles. So, if you've ever been to Disney, and I know I talk a lot about Disney on this channel, but that's who I am. And anyways, if you've ever been to Disney, they used to put the Christmas lights on Disney, or on Cinderella's castle. And it kind of looked like this. Of course, it was a whole lot better because it's Disney, right? But
that's what it was. They didn't do it this year due to COVID and trying not to have the big draw of crowds. So there's the Nutcrackers. I love the reflection on the water. Another science thing, reflection. So I know a lot of my students watch my channel, and that's why I point out things like that. Just because I'm hoping that it will help them out too. So some of y'all who don't watch it for that, I apologize, but I'm really hoping that my students will, it'll stick with them, you know what I mean? So look at the red and green trees. That's cool. I like that. So we have the poinsettia tree right there. It looks pretty from far away. It looks so beautiful.
That one?
And now we're going down this way. I don't know which way this is. But here's the boot tower. Christmas tree boots. So here's the Christmas light tunnel.
Mira, mira.
So those of y'all who have glasses and have to wear a mask, you know the troubles of wearing it and your glasses fogging up. So it's hard for me to tell what I'm actually recording because it looks weird through fogged glasses. And there we go with the trees. I like how they did the trunks white and the tops blue. That looks really cool. With the menorah right here. We're gonna go into Fireside S'mores. We're not gonna do any s'mores, but I'm gonna go look in there. And it's just a resting area. Look at the fire. Ah, nice and warm by the fire. And we got some live entertainment up there. So you can roast marshmallows. And they do even have where you can roast marshmallows here. Real fire. So that was neat. I would guess that you can get your s'more stuff over there. Love the reflections. So here's the candy cane area or Candyland area. So here we got the different colors. on the trees. Very nice. Again, you got the different colored lights on the trunk of the trees. Both sides. A whole lot coming up. So we're coming into the candy cane light tree area, which I really like. This is towards the front of the park. So basically I've seen everything both day and night now. And the stuff that we didn't get to see, I'm kind of upset about, but oh well. That's how it goes. That's why you need to come more than once during the season. We're getting the Coca-Cola bears. And no, Coca-Cola is not sponsoring me. That was my day at SeaWorld for the Christmas stuff. I really enjoyed it overall. So I suggest you come out. This will go up barely in time, but you still have time to come out, so do so and enjoy. And with that, thank you for joining me and have a magical day.